Win the incredible Steigercraft, Evinrude, Lowrance Grand Prize Boat Package, and more in the Fisherman's 2018 Dream Boat Fishing Challenge. Get the details at thefisherman.com.
Hey there, Toby Lapinski for the New England edition of the Fisherman Magazine with this week's web video fishing forecast for New England. I'm out here today fishing with Captain Tom Logan of Fish on Charter, sailing out of Westerly, Rhode Island. We started off the day, went out to Montauk, picked up a couple bluefish, and south of Long Island here to target was sharks. We drifted for a bit, had some had the live bluefish going. We had a whole bunker in the water. We had a couple different squid baits out. Some chub mackerel rolled up, so we jigged up a bunch of those, put out a live one, started filling a cooler with the chub mackerels, but unfortunately the sharks so far, as of shooting this video right now, have not shown up. We just had a big school of bunker roll by, so there's still a shot, although right now we switched gears for a little while. Close to the Montauk Point, we're doing a little bottom fishing, pulling up some pretty decent sea bass action, looking for a couple of fluke hopefully along the way as well. Back a little bit closer to home in New England. The striped bass bite in Rhode Island waters is still going strong. I got an email from Dominic Tamburrino. He told me there's some good fish at spots other than Block Island, which is good to hear because that seems to be all I'm hearing is Block Island, Block Island, Block Island. But he went away from the fleet recently and was rewarded with some solid bass to 39 pounds on live eels. Congrats on that nice catch. Those inshore waters off South County and over through Newport right now have a load of small bait, so things are set up perfectly for an excellent inshore fall run. We will see what happens there. Continuing along with striped bass, the Canal remains the absolutely most consistent bite for surf fishermen pretty much up and down the coast right now, not just in New England. And it's unfortunately, though, there's a lot of people, it's come at a bit of a cost as there's been fights, there's been thefts, vehicle break-ins, and even alleged stabbing have taken place up there in the last few days. So if you plan to head up there and fish, just remember, keep your cool, work with your neighbor as opposed to against them. There are fish from schoolies to the mid 30 pound class to be had. And from the guys I talked to, they're the subsurface bite, obviously throughout the night, but even into the daytime, has been better with jigs and the old magic swimmer being best bet. But keep that top water ready because they have been popping up, taking baits on the surface as well. On the fluke side of things, we received some much better reports of fluke in Eastern and Long Island Sound, but there are still some solid doormats to the west. As I received an email from Kelly Magyari with pictures of a 10.05 pound fluke that she landed this week while fishing off of Milford, Connecticut. Congratulations on new personal best for Kelly. Sea bass and porgies are also feeding heavily pretty much throughout the sound, with porgies just about everywhere. Sea bass, though, noticeably have been moving to the deeper water from what I'm hearing. One species, though, that has been rather non-existent in New England in our weekly reports throughout much of the season is the bluefish. There's just a few small bites taking place off the south side of the Cape back in the spring. There's been some popping through a Block Island, a couple here shots here and there at the race, but very few anglers have been running into them in large numbers anywhere for any extended amount of time. And to show this, we only have 5 of the available 10 slots filled for the Dream Boat Challenge right now. But we did get 2 bluefish New England entries this week. Subscriber John Free Owen weighed in a 16.11 pound bluefish at Bobby J's in Milford on Sunday. And there's a 16.12 pounder from New England also on the leaderboard. And again, the current leader in the bluefish category is 16.5 pounds. So there's plenty of room to get on the leaderboard. Get yourself one step closer to winning the grand prize, a brand new 23-foot Steigercraft boat in the 2018 Fisherman Magazine Dream Boat Challenge. All right, well, there you have it. As always, if you're looking for more information, I didn't get to your species of choice, be sure to check out all of the fishing reports posted at thefisherman.com. And if you plan to head out and fish this weekend, wishing you tight lines.
Hey anglers, the Fisherman Surf and Inshore Fishing Show is Wednesday, September 12th at the Huntington Hilton. See seminars by the region's best surf and inshore experts. First 500 through the doors receive a goodie bag worth more than the price of admission. Check out the free workshops and see more than 75 vendors with the latest fishing gear. Don't miss this opportunity to get ready for the fall run. Visit thefisherman.com for more information.